Namaste viewers, welcome back to Gnana Devula channel. We have been seeing the Ramayana, in snippets of Ramayana, in a series of videos. Now this particular video is exclusively on Anjaneya, Hanumanta, Anjana Putra, called by so many names, because he had the ability of a very great intelligence, and he was a great sadhaka. He had to his credit lot of sadhanas. Let us go through them one by one. Ashta Siddhis, they are called as. Ashta Siddhis means 8 of the sadhanas, which are very useful, and then which are of importance to us in our daily life also. But before that, my request is to subscribe to the channel, like this video, and share this video with your friends and then families, etc. Lord Anjaneya Hanuman believed to have mastered the 8 great sciences. They are known as Ashta Siddhis. These are some kind of divine abilities that provide an absolute power over various aspects in life and then in the universe. Let us see each of them. One is called as the anima. Anima. That is, anima is small thing. The ability to become smaller and smaller and smaller. You have a normal size, you have a big size, and you have to bring it to the normal size. Hanuman could attain miniature forms. He could reduce in his weight, he could reduce in his size, becoming many, many times smaller. This was useful for entering anywhere, any in small miniature forms, and then lot of other things, spying and everything. The takeaway lesson from this is, it symbolizes that you have to reduce your ego, you have to reduce your greed and negativity in life. This is anima siddhi. The next one is garima, mahima. Anima, mahima. Mahima is increasing in size. You have a normal size, you grow and then become increasingly in your volume, you grow to a great extent. Hanuman could grow to gigantic proportions during at times of war and at times of battles and things like that. So this is the physical nature. The physical nature of a body can grow to some extent. One may have doubt, one may express doubt whether it is possible or not. I think to some extent it is possible. We think it is possible because we have seen people, tying threads to their shoulders, and then by tightening the shoulders, the thread gets cut. This is increasing in the size of the muscular. The muscular size is increased. This is mahima. Probably there were great, he was a very great achiever in increasing his proportion. So the takeaway lesson here is, it represents increasing confidence, increasing and setting higher goals, and maintaining a kind of an open mind. This is mahima siddhi. Then garima. Garima is another siddhi, another kind of achievement. It is increasing in weight. See, you have some weight, But if you want, you can increase your weight and then you can increase your the total weight. Hanuman could become as heavy as a very big rock, very big mountain like this. It teaches having unshakable morals and principles, that you have a firmness and you have unshaking and firmness in morals and principles. This garima, you can see when Hanuman, he puts his foot on somewhere and then nobody is able to shake that, no matter how many in the battleground or whoever tries to pull it out, he is incapable of pulling it. This is garima siddhi, which teaches unshakable morals and principles. Then you have laghima. Laghu means being weightless. Laghu, light, that is as light as a cotton, lump of cotton like this. This is decreasing weight. Hanuman and other, there are so many people, demigods we call them, could make their bodies lighter than the feather, allowing them to float in the air. They had the capacity to reduce their weight, by which, they could float. They used to, fly in the air like this. So, the takeaway lesson here is encourages maintaining a light-heartedness, light spirit and mental freedom. If you apply this to our life, probably physically we may not be able to achieve that. But mentally, it encourages maintaining a light spirit and then freedom of our mind. Then, prapti. Prapti is getting whatever they want immediately, instantly. Attaining anything immediately. See, these people, the persons who had mastery over this prapti could manipulate surrounding molecules, manipulate surrounding things to create anything they desire. This was the capability. Emphasizes seeking peace and happiness. Prapti is another kind of a Ashta Siddhi. It is the fifth of the Ashta Siddhi. While previous Siddhis uses to manipulate their own body, this Prapti allows the user to collect all the things from outside, surroundings, manipulate the surroundings and create something which they desire. They can create anything, absolutely anything they desire immediately. One can create anything they need instantly, manipulating the molecules in the surroundings. One should try to attain peace, happiness, mental peace. This is the greatest takeaway from this prapti, siddhi. Then prakamya. Prakamya is, it's a siddhi. It's something which one can adaptability. Provides adaptability. One can be so adapted that they can live anywhere, under any circumstances. They can live underwater, extend their life span many times to original lifespan, survive in very extreme climates such as cold or hot climate, moisture, without air, all those kinds of things, This is one, Lord Hanuman had attained this siddhi, and he had taught to other many demigods and sages so that they can do more good works. That is the intention. See, now on the mountains you can see Sherpas, they have a more lung power and then they can just do lot of things. but which we cannot do. From the plains, people going from the plains, they will not be able to go higher and higher. These are certain things, you know, to an extent we can, we can achieve these kinds of things. Then we have this prapti prakamya, adaptability. Finding happiness in any situation, adaptability, prakamya, we can call it as. Ishatva. Ability to control over the five elements of nature. See, these are called as Pancha Mahabhutas. Air, water, fire, space, then Akasha, Prithvi, Earth, all these things, you know. They have control over this nature. They can command wind, earth, fire. Signifies a strong presence that can influence the environment. These people can influence the environment itself. That is, Ishatva grants the these people to influence the Pancha Bhuta elements. After attaining Ishatva, the wind moves with their will, earth as their will, fire will not burn them. The nature listens and obeys the commands of the Ishatva user. This is the thing that the person who is having this Ishatva, Ashta Siddhi, will change environment at their will. This is the Ishatva Vidya. Then the other thing is called as Vashitva. That is Vasha. That means getting hold of the person. Communication with and control over others' minds. It is a kind of hypnosis, hypnotic way. See, he is able to control the other's mind. He is able to control him. He can order him. He can do whatever they want. This has been practiced in many times, you know. This is influencing others. We see many people are being influenced by us, and then we are also being influenced by others. Of course, this is, users can make people and animals and other living beings also act according to their will. This we find. Dogs being trained, animals being trained in circus, where leader or whoever, you know, he orders animals to sit, stand, run, do what all kinds of acrobatics he wants them to do. This is Vashitva. To a large extent, we see them being used even during these days also. This is Vashitva. Communication with and control over others' minds, including animals. The lesson, takeaway lesson is, it encourages fostering love and connection between individuals, between our surroundings, all surroundings with others. As this Siddhi enables communication with all other living beings. So these are all eight vidyas: Anima, Mahima, Gharima, Laghima. Anima is becoming smaller, Mahima is becoming larger, Garima is becoming heavier, Laghima is becoming lighter, Prapti is getting anything instantly, Prakamya, adaptability, Ishatva is control over five elements of nature, all the surroundings, and then Vashitva is communication with and control over others' minds and all those things. These are all eight vidyas which Anjaneya, that Hanumanta, had mastered. To summarize, these Siddhis represent not only extraordinary powers, but also carry some kind of moral and spiritual lessons, guiding individuals to develop positive qualities and values in their lives. Viewers, with this explanation, this is one of the qualities which Anjaneya had, and many of us would like to have at least a part of it. Many of us should have a little, at least a little part of it, a small, if not that to that extent, a minuscule part of it should have it. So we thought we'll explain this in detail. So I hope this you have liked it. Please press your like button there. Like, share with your friends and relatives and all your contacts, and subscribe to our channel to view such series of such videos. This is a part of Ramayana series describing Hanuman's characteristics. Thank you once again.